So why are some jobs just more motivating than others? In the last video, we identified three variables that affect motivation. We identified the individual and that individual's needs and desires, the job itself, and the influence of the manager's actions on the individual and the job. I'd like to introduce you to Hackman and Oldham's job characteristics model. This model very much focuses on the job itself. Hackman and Oldham propose 5 key job characteristics. 5 core job characteristics. The first is skill variety. Skill variety is very much the degree to which we engage in a variety of skills within the job. You can imagine if you're working on an assembly line doing the same task day in and day out, it can be potentially quite demotivating. If you look at the task identity, it's very much the degree to which your job leads you to the completion of something. The more you can feel a part of a final product or outcome, the more you can see something happening or a final product, the more task identity and attachment you have to that result. Task significance is very much around the degree to which our work and our job has an impact on the lives of those around us. Not all of us can be brain surgeons or heart surgeons, but it's nice to know you're making a difference and that there's a greater purpose involved within your work. Autonomy is around the degree to which an individual can play a role in how and when they get that job done. Having that individual responsibility and accountability can really be motivating for some people. This feedback isn't the feedback that you're thinking of. Typically, feedback you think from managers, but this is actually feedback based on your performance in your job and that immediate feedback as to how you did in completing that. So I'm going to add feedback from your job. When you think about myself as a professor, I know if all your heads are down on the desk, that feedback is right there as to how I'm doing my job. A comedian knows it, telling jokes and getting an awkward silence or just hearing crickets or a big roar of laughter is immediate feedback in the performance from the job. If we look at these 5 core job characteristics, we want to consider them as a collective. We want to consider those that we lead and cater our management and leadership approach to those individuals. Different characteristics then elicit different psychological states. So let's take a look at some of those psychological states. If we look at these three very much derive a meaningfulness of work for individuals. If we look at autonomy very much helps produce a sense of responsibility. And our feedback helps people understand and grasp the knowledge of the results and how they did. If we can have our individuals, or if we can inspire our individuals to reach these psychological states, we are certain to help achieve some very positive outcomes for ourselves within organizations. First and foremost, they're going to be motivated. So there's going to be a sense of motivation. When we consider satisfaction can be twofold. And that satisfaction can be with respect to the job, and also with respect to opportunity for individual growth. Overall, individual effectiveness will be impacted. Ultimately, you have the opportunity as a manager to see all of these increase in our employees. What might go down and what hopefully might go down? Well, absenteeism. And hopefully, we'll see a decrease in turnover. Now that's time well spent if we can get to these core outcomes. As a manager, we can't just look at the individuals. We need to look at the job itself and what it is within that job that helps influence an individual. Ultimately, with all of these, as an organization, there's an opportunity for increased profit, a quality product, and overall quality in what we're doing as an organization. Now, doesn't that sound like time well spent?